Good morning, dear children. Let's continue the chapter. We have studied that Reverencing brought these two girls, wolf girls, in the orphanage, and it was quite difficult for Mr. and Mrs. Singh to teach them that they were human beings or eating in a proper way, because all the activities these two girls were doing just like animals. So let's continue the chapter, The Wolf Children, Part 2. Educating the girls became a big problem. Even after months in the orphanage, no progress had been made. First of all, it was quite difficult to realize them, to make them understand that they were human beings. Secondly, they found educating these girls was a big problem. Even after months in the orphanage, no progress had been seen. Many months were over, but there was no improvement in these two girls. It was clear the girls did not think like humans. These two girls were not thinking like humans. For them, it was more natural to behave like wolves because they were living with wolves from the beginning. So they were doing everything like wolves, and it was quite easy for them. Then both girls fell seriously ill, and sadly, Amla died of kidney disease on September 21st, 1921. Suddenly, both the girls were seriously ill. Okay, and Amla died because of the kidney disease. She was having some kidney problem, and she died on 21st September 1921. For Kamla, the younger wolf girls, death was a terrible setback. Kamla was elder one. Amla was younger one. Younger one died. And after Amla's death, Kamla was very much disappointed. She was very much sad. She howled for many days and refused to eat. All the time she was screaming, shouting, and was not eating anything. All she would do was sniff round for Amla's scent. Everywhere she was roaming here and there, and she was just trying to sniff. Sniff means having smell of something. And she was just sniffing round for Amla's scent. Gradually, Kamla turned to Mrs. Singh and slowly began to respond to the woman's patience and kindness. Very slowly, Kamla turned towards Mrs. Singh. Now, Mrs. Singh started to see the good result of her hard work. And now, she slowly started to give response to Mrs. Singh. At last, she started to eat cooked meat, and the day came when she made her first human sound. It was a very happy moment for Mrs. and Mr. Singh that she started eating cooked meat like human beings, and she spoke a first word. Mrs. Singh massaged Kamla's hind legs every day, because her legs were very weak. They were not standing upright. They were all the time the legs were bent. Okay, so every day she gave massage to her legs to strengthen them. This was done so that Kamla could stand upright. Early in 1922, she could walk on her knees, and a few months afterwards rose up on her two legs for the first time. Slowly and gradually, after the regular massage and hard work of Mrs. Singh, now Kamla was able to stand on her two legs. It was a wonderful moment for Mrs. Singh, who had patiently spent hours with Kamla. When Mrs. Singh saw Kamla standing on her legs. It was very exciting and happy moment for Mrs. Singh. The Reverend Singh was also delighted. He was also very much happy. He held out his arms like a proud father as Kamla took her first few faltering steps. Faltering steps means hesitating steps. We know that in the beginning, when small child start learning how to walk, is using faltering steps, hesitating steps. The child just take one or two steps and again, he sits down on the floor. The same way when Kamla started walking, Reverend Singh was very much delighted. He was very much happy and excited. Mrs. Singh was pleased with Kamla for another reason. She could see from Kamla's expression that she was happy to have pleased the Reverend Singh. There was another reason for Mrs. Singh to be happy. What was the other reason? She could see from Kamla's expression that she was happy to have pleased the Reverend Singh. When Reverend Singh was happy seeing her walking, there was a happy and cheerful expressions on Kamla's face also. By seeing Kamla's face, Mrs. Singh was very much delighted. No longer was she the terrified wolf child. Now she was not a terrified, afraid wolf child. She started recognizing herself like a human being. Now Kamla began to trust humans. She would bound towards Mrs. Singh when it was time for her to have her milk, and she would enjoy rides on the swing. Whenever she was feeling hungry, she was going to Mrs. Singh. She started expressing herself and she was enjoying rides on the swings in the garden. She became used to wearing a dress and she tried to learn to speak. Now she was wearing dresses like human beings and started also she tried to learn to speak. Kamla understood most of the things that were said to her, but she spoke very little herself. She was able to understand whatever others were speaking, but she was not able to speak. Very few words she could speak. Even so, she managed by 1929 to learn about 50 words. Till 1929, she could learn about 50 words. In the orphanage garden, she started talking to the flowers and animals. In her free time, she was just going in the garden and she was talking to the flowers and animals. She was enjoying there. When she thought nobody could hear, she would sing lots of little phrases. When she was thinking that nobody is looking at her, she was singing lots of phrases. It's whatever was coming in her mind. She was just uttering few words and singing. For hours, she would sing away to her audience of chickens, goats, puppies, and trees. Her audience were these animals, chickens, goats, puppies, and trees. They were listening Kamla's songs. Then Mrs. Singh was forced to leave the orphanage for several weeks. Again, there was a very sad moment for Kamla because Mrs. Singh was forced to leave the orphanage. Her aunt was seriously ill. Kamla couldn't understand why Mrs. Singh had left her. As Mrs. Singh's aunt was seriously ill, she left the orphanage and went to her aunt's house. And this girl, Kamla, was very much disappointed. She could not understand why she left the orphanage. For 2 weeks, she went back to her old ways. For 2 weeks, whatever she was doing earlier, she started doing the same. She sat in a dark corner, swaying backwards and forwards. She refused her food. She stopped singing to herself. She was just sitting in the dark corners and she was shaking herself front and back, and she was not eating her food, and she stopped even singing to herself. At last, Mrs. Singh returned. She returned back to the orphanage. "Quick, Kamla, Mama has come back," someone cried. The words acted like magic. Kamla ran to greet Mrs. Singh. Both were overjoyed to see each other. Finally, somebody came and gave her information that Mrs. Singh has returned back to the orphanage. Kamla, it was a great miracle, a great magic for Kamla. She just ran towards her and greeted her, and both of them were overjoyed, very happy. Kamla refused to let go of Mrs. Singh's hand for the rest of the day. Rest of the whole day, she just folded Kamla, Mrs. Singh's hand, and walked wherever she went. That night, the Reverend Singh sat in her study writing up his notes. As he finished writing, he smiled to himself. Kamla had learned something more important than how to walk and talk. She had learned how to love a human being. That night, Reverend Singh was sitting in his study room and he was writing down something, and he was very much happy because Kamla, more than walk and talk, Kamla had learned how to love human beings, and it was a great news. It was a great thing for Reverend Singh, so he was very much happy. On November 14, 1929, Kamla died as Amla had done of kidney failures. As Amla died the same way, having kidney disease, kidney failure, Kamla also died on 14th of November 1929. She was greatly mourned by the Singhs and the rest of the children in the orphanage. The whole orphanage, all the children and Mr. and Mrs. Singh were very much sad after her death. So, dear children, I hope you understood this chapter. Read it twice, four times, and understand it. Thank you.